Just about 1% of the coffee that's drunk in Australia is actually locally grown. Australians love to drink coffee, and they're especially fond of high quality coffee. Even though Australia is a huge continent, there's only very few pockets that are suitable to grow coffee. Coffee is very finicky, doesn't like frost at all, it likes rich soils. So a lot of areas are not suitable for coffee, or they're competing with other crops. So the few pockets where we do grow coffee is here in northern New South Wales and up in the Atherton Tablelands in northern Queensland. The variety they're using at the moment is very tall and very leggy. When they decided on it about 20 years back, it was the most productive and high quality variety, but unfortunately it just never stopped growing. So what the industry is looking for is a new variety that will stay at a semi-dwarf stage of around 2 meters, which allow continuous machine harvesting without having to prune regularly. What we're trying to achieve is to find a variety that's better suited than what's typically grown in this region. We're getting funded from Agrifutures through the emerging industries portfolio. So their goal would be to have coffee 10 million gross value every year in 5 years. That can only be achieved if we do find a new variety that can replace the old variety.
We're trying to produce a good coffee cherry with the good beans in there. From that cherry to a cup of coffee, there are still lots of processing need to be done. And for example, there's a different post-harvest processing and maybe require a different drying, different fermentation process. And we also want to find the scientific evidence behind a good cup of coffee. There may be a different variety of coffee can be grown in Australia. And each of variety could actually have a different flavor characteristics. For example, some coffee is very floral, some coffee may be very fruity. What we are doing here is trying to standardize the terminology to describe a cup of coffee. So we can find 50,000 different chemical markers in a cup of coffee. And what we're trying to do is trying to link with these sensory data come from coffee tasting panel to these 50,000 chemical markers. And so later we can actually reproduce the same cup of coffee with the same flavor. As we can produce a good glass of wine in Australia, I believe we can also produce a good cup of coffee.